My name is Gregory Porter, jazz singer, informed by soul and gospel, blues. I'm singing about things that I know about, the pain, the love of my mother, the scar that comes from injustice, racism, deep love that comes from every, corner. It doesn't have to be just your loved one. I mean, your wife or your girlfriend. There's your brother, there's your community, there's your, older mothers in the neighborhood. I feel that kind of energy, and that comes out in the music as well.
I do not agree. This is not for me, no. Musical genocide. I will not commit, nor will I submit to musical genocide.
Gregory Porter really leaped out at me from the radio. I was driving around in my car, listening to the local jazz station, and the song Illusion from his first record came on. At first, you hear the intimacy of this voice. It's an incredible texture to his voice. It's like Lester Young or something like that. Really, really warm and just cuts right through to you.
Strength, power, I could say virility, and sensitivity at the same time. Just probably everything that you'd want in a voice.
That's the first thing you hear, obviously. He's just amazing, amazing voice. But he's writing songs for that voice, and he's writing songs that you're not hearing today.
I always felt like the subject matter that I could choose with jazz was just always so wide open. On this upcoming album, there may be, a subtle protest song, but also, I can sneak in a lullaby, and then I could say something, about God and love.
Appreciate
it. No problem. All right, so
where will we be? Hey, what's up? Testing one. Hey, Laura, it's me. Sorry, but I had to ring your doorbell so late. There's something bothering me. I really am sorry, but it just couldn't wait. Is there someone else instead of me?
You could just get lost in the sound of his voice on recordings, but that's if you've never seen him live.
I was knocked out by the performance because although he's got all this amazing technique, He never uses it for the sake of technique.
I heard another singer who was on the same bill opening up for him, and how she described him was, he's a beast. She just felt there was really nothing to compare him to, and it was not a position you wanted to be on, being on the same stage or opening up or coming on after him.
I'm amazed by the level of acceptance of my voice and some of the things that I like to sing, and because part of it is part of the music is my personality, and so the other night I was singing with Diane Reeves on stage, and she didn't say, "Oh man, I love your voice." She said, "I like who you are," and that was heavy. That was heavy for me because, that's probably where I am musically. I'm just trying to put me inside of the music and be organic and be human.
I feel just like a kite, but one without a string.
At Blue Note Records, we're trying to present artists who are authentic. That's really what we look for, authenticity and integrity and soul and groove. And man, if he isn't the living embodiment of that, I don't know who is.
Is a connection to our past. in a wonderful way.
That reminds me a lot of some of the songwriters from the sort of 70s soul period, like Bill Withers or Curtis Mayfield. But he's putting it in a jazz context.
When you say you want to be free, free to sing, free
keep on doing what you're doing. Keep hearing those beautiful songs.
The last Greg Porter song I hear is my favorite. And then I hear another one. That's my favorite.
Unreroute the rivers, let the damned water beat. There's some people down the way that's thirsty, so let the liquid spirit free. The people are thirsty because of man's unnatural hand. Watch what happens when the people catch wind, when the water hits the banks of that hard, dry land. Clap your hands now.